I'm just going to talk about the initiative today, which I play a small role in as a researcher. We call it the Seed Knowledge Initiative, we call it SKY, not SKI, so it's SKY. And it actually has a very long background of collaboration between University of Cape Town, where we are based in environmental and geographical science. That department, specifically through Rachel Weinberg, and BioWatch South Africa, which is an NGO which works along the protection of biodiversity, agroecology, and small-scale farmers' rights. So why I'm here on behalf of Rachel really is to seek and strengthen collaborations with other research institutions working on agroecology, such as yourselves, and possibilities are joint supervision of students. I know there's definitely scope for students to do work in Zambia. One of our partners has requested that we can find students. They've got topics for them to research, collaborative research proposals, or simply the discussion of common areas of interest. All right, let's see. Amazing. So the evolution of SKY, we are now in the second phase and preparing for a third phase. We've been very fortunate in having a very supportive main funder, which is SDC, or the Swiss Development and Cooperation Agency. But SKY kicked off in 2013 with these three core partners, so UCT, BioWatch South Africa, and what is now known as EarthLaw, with connections to Gaia, as you say. It used to be another NGO, but it's now EarthLaw. So, but our funder said that we couldn't be South Africa specific. We needed to be regional, and specifically SADC. So in phase two, we moved and accumulated more partners. Some of them whom you might know, there's Soils, Food and Healthy Communities in Malawi. There's the Kasisi Agricultural Training Center in Zambia. There's the Zambia Alliance for Agroecology and Biodiversity Conservation. Then in moving to Zimbabwe, there's PORET, Participatory Organic Research, Extension and Training. Ukuvuna is run by John Azira. He is Zimbabwean by birth, but he lives in Johannesburg, so he has a permaculture demonstration farm in just outside Johannesburg called, and Ukuvuna is his organization. CTDT, this is a CTDT from Zambia, not Zim. They are the Community Technology and Development Trust. SELACT is also in Zimbabwe. Chukukwa Ecological Land Use Community Trust. ZIMSOF, the organic farmers. RESCOPE is again in Zambia. Regional Schools and Colleges of Permaculture. So forgive me, I only see them at meetings. I don't do the partner gathering. But we are, and let me just show you the geographic spread of our partners, and looking forward, we are hoping to grow, not enormously, but certainly organically within the region. And definitely we've started connecting with organizations in Lesotho and Swaziland, particularly around the issue of GM contamination of smallholder farms and crops, or maize specifically, because as you know, South Africa, more than 80% of our maize is GM, and there is definitely a chance of cross-border contamination. So, I'm just doing weird things. This is just a photo of some of our partners, some of whom you may know. This was taken at one of our planning meetings in February 2017. Now, Sky's vision is to collaborate on multiple levels, both within South Africa and regionally, to work towards a future where small-scale farmers are empowered to secure their own seed and food sovereignty. These photos just depict some of the activities that Sky fosters and facilitates. Farmers associated with BioWatch at the top. This year they didn't do it, but they've organized themselves a yearly march against Monsanto, where they then deliver their grievances to the local Department of Agriculture, because we live in an agricultural world where our Department of Agriculture actually gives out samples of GM maize and hybrids and GM to small-scale farmers. A lot of the extension work has been taken over by companies such as Syngenta and Monsanto. And these farmers who are practicing agroecology do not want those samples. They usually feed the seed to their chickens or just simply refuse to take them. Other pictures show seed phases, particularly Zimbabwe is very active in regional and local and district seed phase. So Sky's aim is to revive and enhance traditional seed knowledge systems and to deepen understanding about their functioning. This takes place within the context of agroecological production and cultural awareness. Sky has four interrelated objectives. These address issues at four different levels, you could say. Firstly, there's at farmer and community level. Then amongst networks, there's an advocacy level. And finally, also a strong research component with a strong focus on being socially responsive and responsible. So for us, it's important that any research undertaken in Sky is either informed by developments at the grassroots level or farmers' needs, or otherwise acts upon issues which warrant further research in order to achieve our vision and aim. Sky has a theory of change, which can be summarized as here, where we live in a context of expanding industrial agriculture. As you may know, South Africa has a very strong commercial industrial agriculture sector, and the current move from the government is to foster more black farmers in the commercial. They're almost ignoring the small scale farmer who doesn't want to become commercial or who doesn't want to grow GM crops. They're not on the radar at all. There's a big push for commercial black farmers. Then of course you know about the Green Revolution for Africa, which is being pushed on multiple levels. Intellectual property on seed is definitely, especially in Zambia and Malawi, with new seed laws being passed, ours is also on the cusp of becoming an act, where they correspond to the UPA of 1991, which is very restrictive towards small-scale farmers' rights to sell and exchange seed, and in fact will criminalize acts such as seed exchange. So within that context, Sky sees change happening at three different levels, individually, community, and then societal. On the individual level, we work with so-called change agents. They're mostly, in South Africa, mostly women farmers. They are given training, mentoring, information on agroecology and seed saving and other practices. So this leads to improved AE practice and skills and confidence at an individual level. Then it moves to community level, where AE practice is spread between and within communities, And sometimes this happens across borders when we have farmer exchanges with Zimbabwe, for example, or Lesotho. And so Sky does training with those communities that show an interest, also civil society organizations. Again, information, research, exchange, and link building links. Then this change hopefully manifests as stronger networks of rural communities and civil society organizations advocating for support for their agroecological approach to farming. Societal change is effected through research, through interacting with the media, the production of films, sharing of stories, stories of change and success, and also lobbying decision makers. The desired transformation at that level is, it's still a bit early for us to say, but we're hoping it will be reflected in a change in the discourse and policy. So our impact over time, we really hope that Sky's intervention will result in rural communities exercising their right to seed and food sovereignty and influencing norms, policies, and practices which ensure wide use of traditional agroecological food production systems. Ultimately, this guarantees their food security, it protects agrobiodiversity, and it will strengthen community cohesion as well as women's positions. Knowledge exchanges, as just to go deeper into one of our activities, there's not only, so these farm exchanges are facilitated by Sky and where seed gets exchanged, but also knowledge, cultural knowledge gets exchanged because there's so much cultural difference. In some communities, especially through Earth Law, that's part of their work is to revive traditional ceremonies around sacred places because these places are often untouched by modern agriculture and that's where a lot of agrobiodiversity can be found. Women's role as seed custodians is strengthened. There's advice given on practical things such as seed storage and conservation. Sky likes to work at a household level initially so that all farmers are seed secure at home before perhaps even thinking about a community seed bank, which is happening more and more in Zimbabwe, but in South Africa it hasn't been very successful. So we try to emphasize household seed security first. We explore the important links between seed and climate variability, and of course also nutrition and agrobiodiversity. Capacity building happens through community dialogues, which build confidence and focus. There's training of farmers and especially identified seed custodians, they get extra training on how to, they have, for example, they have seed plots where those crops are only for seed production and they get special treatment and they're not on the periphery, they're on the inside and they're different things that the farmers practice. Sky hosts seed fairs, seed market days, food and seed festival. They had a big food festival in Durban last year, which unfortunately I couldn't go to. Then exchange visits, and they also demonstration plots or sites and field days. And these are lovely. They are the chicken, where the chickens sleep on the border with Swaziland. So I think it's a Swazi thing. So these are some of the farmers that BioWatch works with. And these are just a few of the crops that the farmers grow at home. You'll see traditional maize. The legumes, there are so many beans. Most of the farmers I interviewed had a minimum of 5 different types of beans. And I believe in Zimbabwe there's much more than that. They have pearl millet, cowpeas, I think, and okra.
They're a pretty formidable looking bunch.
The farmers? Yes. Oh, yes. And they're becoming more and more confident. So research, I wanted to just zoom into that seeing as we're here. So far, most of the research has been led by us at the University of Cape Town through postgraduate students. We have collaborated with GENOC, it's the Norwegian Center for Biosafety. We have collaborated with ETH Zurich, it's the Swiss Federal Institute of Technology, where we actually had a road trip early this year to, they showed us how to use the simple technology to detect GM contamination in the field. So luckily the place we went to, there was no contamination because it's pretty remote on the Swazi border, but on a previous trip they did find 4 out of 24 farmers tested positive for GM contamination of their maize, and they were absolutely shocked because they never accept GM maize, but of course farmers around them do, seeing as it's given to them on a silver platter. We've done a curriculum survey of the curricula in South Africa, which is a bit shocking, where not a single institution which does postgraduate degrees or even diplomas that extension workers go to study, not a single one even mentions agroecology. They all gear towards the commercial way of farming. But that's about to change, luckily, because BioWatch is running a short course at a local institution from the next semester, which starts in July. So there's also farmer-based research where they learn from each other at demonstration plots. In the future, we want to look at these, and those are just two things that's on the radar, HIV/AIDS and youth, and their connection to seed and agriculture. Then also the feasibility of community seed banks, because this has been quite a contested area. Every year, Sky has a very, say, a strong M&E program that we all have to take part in. Not my favorite, but we try to do it as participatory as possible, where farmers map their own seeds, there's community mapping of what they have at their home, how compliant they are with the 8 principles of agroecology, and they are more and more doing this themselves. So the M&E is not just imposed on them. At UCT, these are the theses that we have at the moment. The orange ones are completed. They are mostly masters, and there's a couple of honors students. You can read for yourself, but we have three, we're very excited about three PhD students. They're all various stages of finishing. I would say Maya is probably the closest. She's looking at agricultural knowledge systems across from the laboratory to small-scale farmers and the disconnect. And she's also bringing in an artistic component. We'll have as part of her PhD, which is quite exciting. Kudzai is in Zimbabwe. He's actually, interestingly, the manager of the National Gene Bank in Harare. And he's our PhD student, so it's been wonderful to have his insight. He's looking at the resilience of farmer-led seed systems. And Bulistani, interestingly, he works for our funder, SDC. So there's a lot of cross-pollination going on, and he is looking more at the links between farmer-led seed systems and food security. Then, just a few recent publications. It's all quite new for us, publishing this sort of thing. This is just a briefing document that Rachel and I did and Lawrence on seed banking, especially at home state level. And those other papers are all available. I think they're all open access, but you can always ask me if you're interested in reading them. Then, finally, what we're quite excited about is, and something I would like to open up to you if you're interested and around, we are hosting a conference on agroecology, on every aspect of agroecology, and also as a movement, as a practice, as a political statement. To my knowledge, it's the very first one in South Africa, and it will definitely be in Cape Town. We've set the provisional dates of the end of January. We're sending out a call for expressions of interest within the next week or so, and I'll circulate it in your. And then we would love it if someone from here would like to present a paper, or there'll be space for academic papers, but also for anything else. If you have a more creative way of bringing your voice on agroecology.